Well, gentlemen, one half of our great adventure is over. We have conceived and given birth to a mighty child. But as I see her at the quayside, I realize it is not just the ship that has backbone of steel, but the people who built her. Good luck to all of us. And God protect us.
I think the great thing about the journey in this series is actually is it's a very emotional journey because we do dig deep into these characters. And we see how the idea of Titanic pulls and pushes their lives.
My main focus with Kieran and his as well was, you know, we need to create a story that people care about and a character that people care about. Because the audience sees this whole story through Mark's eyes. Mark sort of travels with the rich sort of upper class people, and then he's in the bowels of Belfast.
He plays the role of the metallurgist who is essentially dispatched by J.P. Morgan to go and work in Harland and Wolff on building Titanic.
I'd like to introduce someone to you. This is Dr. Mark Muir. He worked on HMS Dreadnought.
I was her chief metallurgist, sir.
Big battleship.
I would like to offer my services to Titanic, Mr. Morgan. I believe you need me to build this ship.
He basically studies the metal, the steel of the ship, and he was the first person of his kind to kind of come on to a big shipping company and analyze how they're building the ships.
I play Joanna Yeager, who was a journalist from New York who came to Belfast and covered the building of the Titanic at the time. And she was also allegedly a friend of J.P. Morgan's.
We need to make a ship that people are compelled to travel on just so they can say that they have.
It's an untold story. The other story, of course, has gotten so much. Even when I was a little kid, I've seen movies about, of course, the voyage and the sinking. But it's a fascinating history. And the characters involved are many, and it's a fascinating time in the European and American history.
It's a flawed society that builds a flawed ship. It is the lives and times of Belfast, the city that built it, the society that built it, and I suppose the attitude that built the ship as well. What kind of people could dream up something like that, go and do it, and then what ultimately is the effect of its loss, of its sinking?
The beautiful drawing office in Harland and Wolff, in Belfast, the original one, has a barrel ceiling which is illuminated with lots and lots of daylight. So we had a very similar atmosphere in this place. We built all the drawing tables, again studying the various reference photographs from Harland and Wolff, from the original place.
Good morning.
Morning, sir.
I need someone to draw something for me. Would you be free?
In this story, there are a lot of challenges for Sophia. She works. She's a worker, and she's a woman worker. So it's a little bit modern in 1912. She fights for what she believes, and she's ready for leave everything for a new life.
I take it as a great compliment to appear here before you. The bold working people of Belfast.
The ship was in the middle of a battle, and this battle was a sociological battle. It was workers wanting unions and rights and information, and health issues were a big concern. You know, there was a tidal wave of a social movement sweeping across Europe from Russia at the time. That landed in Belfast as Titanic was being built.
Now those who employ you should do so knowing that they have a responsibility to you and your families. A responsibility for your safety at work, and a responsibility to pay you fairly.
To achieve these ends, you know, through negotiation, through union membership, through politics, and not go down the route of paramilitary or militant action. And in fact, you will see that he takes one path and his brother takes another.
The fact it was a period piece, I think, makes a big difference to me. There's more lighting opportunities, there's more fun you can have, actually, in many ways, when you're doing something which is not immediately of the present in a very ordinary way. I mean, the whole thing about doing period stuff is all about that. I mean, very often I think you end up with better sets, you end up with more costumes, you end up with, in many ways, photographic, I think, more interesting things you can do.
Costumes, it's always the costumes are so sumptuous and they look edible almost. I remember being quite excited when I met him, thinking of how he'd make it look. I've not been disappointed.
All these clothes were made for me. Something doesn't, if a costume doesn't work and it doesn't feel right on me, he gets rid of it and has another one made. Even extras, like 100 feet away, wearing like the most beautifully designed costumes and hats.
Even the color of the costume are perfect for the ambience and for the light. It's a perfect balance around everybody and everything.
I mean, this is a really big story to tell, and there's a lot of responsibility to tell it, because a lot of people know it. There's a real sense of care, responsibility, to tell the best story that we possibly can.
Kieran Donnelly, the director, I really take my hat off to him, because it is a gargantuan task, and he's fulfilling it incredibly well.
We've built the model of the gantry, we've built the keel and the double hull section, we've built the buildings, all the cabins, the people. So the ship itself that we've built, we've actually built the ship for real. So she's built in the computer, but every plate in there is exact, and the ribs are pretty exact. So there's a lot of love and attention in there, you know, as if you're building a physical model of the ship actually for real.
I so hoped that our ship would be a symbol of what might have been achieved. A unifying force. That was my vision.
You always quoting Brunel, an engineer who never compromised. Both you and I know that this ship is nowhere near as safe as his.
In 8 days' time, we will welcome the RMS Titanic to New York. And when you have seen her, write about her.
As I see her at the quayside, I realize it is not just the ship that has backbone of steel, but the people who built her. I'm glad we're sailing together.
Me too. There's a bigger picture here, bigger than the ships we build.